Welcome to the 73rd annual Jefferson City Jaycees Christmas Parade. My name is Linda McAnany, and along with my friend, Mike Downey, we are the co-anchors of this year's event. Mike, you did an outstanding job with the weather. You know that, don't you?
Well, I'd like to take responsibility for it, but I believe Julie Moore from the Jaycees is primarily responsible for the weather.
And of course, Julie is the chair of the Christmas parade, so she had a vested interest, did she not?
No, she certainly did. She has promised to be involved in all outdoor activities as far as weather coordination.
That's right. And the theme this year is rock and roll Christmas, so you know there's going to be a lot of energy. And when we come back, you'll start seeing some of that energy and some of the events that are happening.
My name is Clayton. I went to a special learning center. Will you be my superhero?
Every United Way donation is super.
I'm Leon. I go to JC Daycare. Will you be my superhero?
I'm Kobe. I go to Special Jordan School. Will you be my superhero?
Support the United Way Community Campaign.
My name is Zan. Will you be my superhero?
Give, advocate, volunteer.
My name is Colton, and I'm a member of the Boys and Girls Club. Will you be my superhero?
That's what it means to live United.
Bernie, I am so proud of you. For God's sakes, you are the Grand Marshal of the Jefferson City Jaycees Christmas Parade. That's exciting, isn't it?
I couldn't be more excited. I think you know more than anybody how much I love Jefferson City, and what a high honor. I tell you what, I've just been kind of giggling ever since Julie called and said that they got to the very bottom of the list of the phone book in Jefferson City and wanted to know if I was free today.
I don't think Fechtel is at the bottom of the phone book. But by the way, I've worked with this man for quite some time in a number of volunteer efforts, and he is truly very humble with the way he approaches not only his business, but also his city commitments and his community commitments. So we're very proud of you, but we're also, it's the right choice, Bernie.
Well, thank you very much, Linda. I appreciate your confidence, and I hope I won't let our city down, because they're great people and just really looking forward to doing this. This is like the culmination of a career or something like that.
Is this the first time that anyone in your family has been the Grand Marshal?
It is.
That's wonderful.
I'm just really excited to represent us. Been here for, of course, everybody I think knows my kids are back to Jefferson City now. That'll be the fourth generation of us to be here in Jeff City, and we love it. And couldn't be prouder of a town, and we're happy to be your representative today.
And by the way, Fechtel Beverage has been around for four generations, you just
Absolutely.
Said, and you've been involved with Fechtel Beverage since the mid-80s,
yep,
is that right?
Yep, mid-80s. Sabrina and I bought the company from my mom after my dad passed away, and as I said, our two oldest kids, Morgan and Andy, have come home so far, and we're still holding out a little hope for Maggie. But just a great place to be, and it's so nice to be able to give back to a community that's given so much to us.
And he's done a wonderful job in doing so. So, Bernie, we're very proud of you. We're very honored to have you as a Grand Marshal. And I know it's about time for you to get down there and get in. What kind of vehicle are you going to be in today?
You know, I don't know, but something tells me it's going to have to be big.
You're not going to be riding with Mike Keel in behind the draw horses, huh?
I don't know. He's bringing his stagecoach to town. I know they went down to the farm to pick it up today, so it could be.
That
would
be
good.
Be.
I don't think he's going to let me drive,
no.
though.
We can't ask for better weather.
Are you overwhelmed? Homemaker Healthcare's mission is for you to maintain your independence by providing mobility, meal preparation, and personal care so you can stay safe in your home. Homemaker Healthcare is a hometown nonprofit United Way agency that has served Mid-Missouri for 40 years. From physical therapy to nursing to caregiver services, let Homemaker Healthcare take care of all your home care needs. Call 635-3900 and ask how we can assist you today. That's 635-3900. Call Homemaker Healthcare right now.
And I'm here with Julie Morf, who's chair of this year's parade. Julie, I guess it's been an exciting experience preparing this parade.
Yeah, it's been very busy.
Probably something you've been working on for about a year or so?
Actually, I just took over this event in August, so yeah.
Oh, so it has been exciting
yeah,
for you.
Yeah, very exciting.
And you've been with the JCs for a number of years.
Yes, since 2004.
Since 2004, and you've held a number of positions both locally and statewide?
That's correct.
And how does the what you're doing for this position, stress-wise and time-wise, compare to the other things that you've done for the parade?
It's different. You definitely have to be organized and be able to take a lot of people calling you and just be able to, you have to be very flexible. So about the same. I think any organization has their ups and downs, but yeah, this is not a bad event.
So what can we expect with today's parade?
Nice weather, because yeah. I asked for it. we have about 69 floats. Santa will be bringing up the end, and lots of lights, lots and lots of lights, and hopefully some happy people and some happy kids getting some candy.
Oh, absolutely. And so can we count on you then when other times when we need great weather, we can count on you to supply that for us?
Sure, just call me.
All right. Well, you know, tell us a little bit more about what JCs do. You know, that they're so visible during, you know, certain periods of the year, mm-hmm. but the JCs are doing things throughout the year. Can you tell us a little more about the JC activities?
There's actually Missouri JCs, and throughout Missouri, they have numerous chapters in numerous cities. They do various things, a lot of charity. JCs are all volunteers, so wherever you see a JC, they're a volunteer. In Jefferson City, we actually put on the Jefferson City fair, and so we put on the fair in July, and then we do this and the other community events, helping raise money.
Well, great. The JC is a great organization, and they've prepared a great, great parade here. It's going to be a nighttime parade. That's always fun, isn't it?
Yes, actually, we're really happy that we got to go back tonight.
And, you know, it's going to light up the whole downtown, and I hope many, many people, many children get an opportunity to come here, see the parade, and get some candy and see Santa Claus.
Yes, actually going to see Santa and Mrs. Claus this year.
Outstanding. All right, well, let's go back to Linda.
You know, the Christmas parade would not be a Christmas parade were it not for an opportunity to talk to one of our service agencies within the community. It's my pleasure to introduce, although you have been with the American Red Cross now for over a year, you mentioned.
Just almost a year.
Dave Griffith is the director of the local American Red Cross, Capital City area.
Uh-huh.
Welcome.
Well, thank you, Linda, and it's a pleasure to be with you. And this particular time of the year reminds us of all those things that we're thankful for. And I can tell you that we have a lot to be thankful
yes,
for
we
here
do.
In Southern Missouri.
And I know particularly since you spent the last couple of weeks on the East Coast reacting to Hurricane Sandy, you've had, as we had talked the other day, you have a whole new concept of appreciation for what we have you not?
I really do. You know, in what happened with Hurricane Sandy, and now they're calling it Superstorm Sandy because of the nor'easter that impacted the community as well. But you've got a town, a city, if you will, of 26 million people and 60 million people that are surrounding that community. And when this storm hit, it hit with an impact like I don't think that many people can even comprehend. I was there for 2 weeks, and I was on the ground for 9 days out in the field. And while you're there, you're doing a job. You're trying to deliver services to those that need it most. You're trying to find the best avenues. You're trying to create partnerships with those people that can get those services delivered. And while you're there, you are doing your job.
Mm-hmm.
And Linda, as I told you earlier, when I got home and I started to decompress, what really has impacted me is that we are here in Bend, Missouri. When we go to bed at night, we lay down and we put our heads on pillows, and we've got lights and
we're
got
warm
everything.
And
there are so many people that are out there. We still have almost 3,000 people that are spending the night every night in a shelter.
Well, although this isn't an opportunity to ask for funds, it certainly is an opportunity
yeah.
for you to encourage volunteers to the American Red Cross.
Really,
if somebody is interested, what do they need to do?
There's training you have to go through to be a volunteer. And they can contact our office here in Jefferson City at 635-1132. We are in desperate need of emergency response vehicle drivers. And We would love to have people come
by. So do they have to have any kind of licensing?
There's no special licenses. They don't need the Class C license. Mm-hmm. We can train them. Those emergency response vehicles, those vehicles feed 400 people
at a
time.
Wow. So if you're interested in helping the American Red Cross and you have those driving skills, please get in touch with them locally, because it sounds as though they can be used. And certainly, David, I know I wish you a very Merry Christmas. I'm sure that all those volunteers who responded, God bless them all.
God bless them. And God bless you for what you do for our community.
It's my pleasure.
Have a Merry Christmas, everybody.
All right, folks.
My name is Clayton. I went to a special learning center. Will you be my superhero?
Every United Way donation is super.
Will you be my superhero?
Will you be my superhero?
I'm Kobe. I go to Stressing Jordan too. Will you be my superhero?
Support the United Way community campaign.
My name is Zan. Will you be my superhero?
Give, advocate, volunteer.
My name is Colton, and I'm a member of the Boys and Girls Club. Will you be my superhero?
That's what it means to live united.
Welcome back to the JC's Christmas Parade. This is the 73rd annual Christmas Parade in Jefferson City, and very, very excited. The streets are lined with people, and everybody's ready for the beginning of the parade.
And as we said earlier, what wonderful weather. It's a little nippy now, but it's wonderful. I have a feeling, we've been doing this for a few years, but I have a feeling this may be a record-breaking crowd, because these people are lined down both sides.
This is certainly the largest crowd we've had in the last few years, I can assure you of that. You know, last year it rained so much that we're just so glad to see all the people out for the parade this year.
Lots of kids, lots of excitement, and you know what? I can hear some bands and I can hear some emergency vehicles. You think they're close?
We are just moments away from the start of the JC's Christmas Parade here in downtown Jefferson City. Pretty exciting stuff.
You know, Mike, there's been a lot going on the last few weeks, and now, between now and Christmas, there's a lot more events going on. We are lucky to live in a community our size where there is excitement and fun times.
Well, that's exactly right. We had the Living Windows last night, and of course we have Capitol Caroling coming up amongst all the other Christmas activities.
And you know, I talked to Sam Bushman earlier, and he was talking about the success of Living Windows last night, and also of the Small Business Saturday that was held 10 days ago?
That's right.
Last week,
great
and
success.
He was very excited with all the events that were going on. So it's good to know there's a lot going on in our community.
Oh, it really is. It's we really do embrace this time of year. Well, there we have it. We have the beginning of the parade. This is, of course, Jefferson City's finest. We have the motorcycle squad, and they will signal the beginning of the 73rd annual Jefferson City Jaycees Christmas Parade.
And following them, of course, will be the VFW post number 1003. I guess that's right.
Yep.
Their honor guard. And of course, it's always good to see the flag of our country along with our state and respectful folks.
Yes, ma'am. It's Jefferson City's finest. And of course, they're followed up by the VFW Post 1003 Honor Guard.
And the Jefferson City JC's banner is being carried by the St. Peter's Girl Scouts, two of those members. And of course, right behind him is our Grand Marshal, Bernie Fechtel.
Our good friend, Bernie Fechtel. Bernie's such a great community guy. Really glad to see him as part of this parade.
You know, we were very fortunate to chat before the parade started and to talk about, he said how, Merry Christmas, Bernie. And he said how proud he was to be a member of our community. He's a very humble man, and he's a wonderful community supporter. You're absolutely right.
He really is. You know, coming up, we've got our first band of the evening. It's the Lincoln University Blue Tiger Band, more commonly known as the Marching Musical Storm, under the direction of Rhonda Harper. And there's 120 members of this great, great band. Let's listen to them now. That's Rhonda Harper right there in the vehicle being driven, and her band is following her up. You know, the great thing about the band, Rhonda speaks about this a lot, is they are a great ambassador for the university. You know, they go out and they perform in a number of parades and always just represent the university very, very well.
And I think they're the number of different types of music that they're able to do is wonderful as well. I mean, they have quite a repertoire.
Yes, they do. University Marching Musical Storm.
Boy, that gets your blood pumping, doesn't it?
It really does. And they are followed up by the Osage Fire Protection District. You can't have a parade without a fire truck.
That's right, and a good horn.
Yep, Devin Harris is the 2012 Jefferson City Jaycees chapter president in that vehicle, I believe.
He's got his hands full.
Yes, he does.
They're followed by the Cole County Girl Scouts, Troop 741. They're celebrating 100 years of existence, Girl Scouts are this year.
That's
great.
100 years of scouting, I did not know that. Kind of dressed as reindeer there. That's wonderful.
That's good. And now we have a whole flatbed of Girl Scouts.
Yes. Girl Scouts are a great activity for young women.
Absolutely.
Yeah, Girl Scouts rock.
That's good. We have a lot of walkers right
we
behind us.
We do have
moms
a lot of walkers.
Other siblings, they're having fun.
Coming up next, we have Hy-Vee. This is Hy-Vee of Jefferson City and its employees, owners, wishing you a Merry Christmas.
Rod Dolph is their store manager, and he is a good community person, and he is very involved. So
what a great float.
That is soup. Music?
Yeah, nice kids throwing out candy. Next, we have Dancer's Alley. Dancer Alley students and faculty light up downtown with some lively dancing. You know, the younger students are riding on the float, which was decorated by the older students.
And the older students are dancing.
Yes, they are.
And I think, if I remember right, these are these are young ladies who are full of energy.
You bet, another great activity for students to do, a little young folks do some dancing.
And they're followed by the Cole County Emergency Response Team. And they represent the Department of Homeland Security and Hazmat as well. And they have their emergency vehicle right behind them.
Yes, they do. Always glad to have those folks in our community to help us when trouble comes.
You know, it just reminds us how fortunate we are, Michael.
Yes, ma'am. Cole County's Emergency Response Team.
This is their CERT team. So it's representing the Cole County Community Emergency Response Team.
Well, we've had a great beginning to the parade. I'm really looking forward to everything else that's coming up. This is just a great, great night for a parade.
Here we have the Central United Church of Christ float. They always do a nice job.
That's a very, very nice float.
The original Rolling Stone. Oh, that's wonderful.
That's beautiful. And they are followed up by another band. It's the Catholic Inter-Parish Band. Parish is from Jefferson City.
It's a junior high school marching band comprised of students from St. Peter's, St. Joseph, and Immaculate Conception schools.
Well, those young people doing a great, great job in the band, you know?
You know, they practice a lot, too. I remember talking to members of that group last year, and they get together quite often and practice, you know, given the fact they're from three different schools. Okay, we have Cub Scout Pack 4 from St. Peter's. They are dressed as rock stars and their fans.
Oh, yeah! Rock and roll, yeah! Pack 4! Oh, here comes one of my favorites, always in the parades. It's the Heart of Missouri Humane Society. And they have some of the puppies there at the shelter that are walking the parade.
Yes, we encourage everyone, if you're thinking about adopting a pet, please get in touch with the new... with our new shelter.
Oh yes, it's a beautiful shelter. Been there a few times recently. Look at all the great puppy dogs you can have there. One of these dogs could be yours.
That's right.
There's one of my favorites, Mufasa. We've been visiting the shelter recently, and he's just a beautiful dog. Someone needs to adopt Mufasa.
You are amazing. Okay, Regional West Fire Protection, the fire truck. I love fire trucks. Fire trucks and bands, that's what parades are all about, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Everybody loves a fire truck in the parade.
And here we have Morrill Heights Cub Scout Pack 11. By the way, this particular pack is celebrating its 75th anniversary, so they've been around for a few years.
Well, they sure have. I believe coming up next, we got Little Mr. and Miss Cole County, and they were crowned during the opening night of the fair.
At the end of July, that's
yes,
right.
Yes, that's right.
It's Cadence Hall and Alex Lewis.
Yes.
Cute kids.
Very cute kids.
Okay, here we have another fire truck. This is the Cole County Fire District, they say fire apparatus.
The fire apparatus, that's correct.
It's a good truck.
You know, we had a
got my attention.
That's right. You know, we had another parade earlier this year, the centennial for the fire department in Jefferson City. Lots and lots of great fire trucks, and it's just great to have them participating in our parades and being part of our community, and more importantly, being there when we need them.
All right. You know, it's my understanding, and my husband and I happened to be out of town, so I didn't get to attend that parade. But it's my understanding that there were literally fire trucks from all over the state.
Oh, there really were. It was great. Hey, you know, let's go ahead and take a break right now.
It's a deal. We'll be right back.
Are you overwhelmed? Homemaker Healthcare's mission is for you to maintain your independence by providing mobility, meal preparation, and personal care so you can stay safe in your home. Homemaker Healthcare is a hometown nonprofit United Way agency that has served Mid-Missouri for 40 years. From physical therapy to nursing to caregiver services, let Homemaker Healthcare take care of all your home care needs. Call 635-3900 and ask how we can assist you today. That's 635-3900. Call Homemaker Healthcare right now.
Welcome back. Thanks for staying with us. My name is Linda McAnany, and Mike Downey and I are the announcers of our Christmas parade this year. And
that's
here
right.
We have a float
right
here.
That's right. We've got the Elite Performing Arts, dancers from the Elite Performing Arts Academy. We have both folks who are riding on the float, and then we've got some dancers that are trailing behind it. Very talented folks there. Some young folks and some young up-and-coming folks. Great, great dancers.
Well, you know, the one fun thing about dancing is it's not only energizing, but it's good exercise, too.
It is good exercise, and it's also something that keeps kids occupied, keep them out of trouble.
That's right. Not that I could kick that high, though. Here we have the Show Me Clowns for Jesus. Christian clowns to spread joy and happiness throughout the community.
Hey, we got a little juggler there. Merry Christmas! They're followed up by
KOMU.
Followed up by our friends from KOMU.
Good buddies.
Great community partner there.
Matt's a good guy. He works. He works well in our community as well.
Here's Holt Summit Fire Protection District. They've got a couple of fire trucks in this year's parade. We've got a modern truck here, and then one that's seen a few years.
And you know what? I can hear the clang, clang, clang of the trolley. That's the Jefferson City Downtown Association. They're riding in the trolley. This trolley company is new to town. It's being a very active part of our community now.
Oh, yes. Of course, Donna Dietz is president of the Downtown Jefferson City Association. And, of course, there she is waving to us
right there.
That's and, of course, she's a part of the trolley company.
I love it. You know, I haven't ridden on the trolley yet.
You know, I believe there's a trolley ride in my future.
Yeah, I think there should be one in both our futures.
You
hopefully
betcha.
We'll have a chance.
Well, once again, this is the Jefferson City Jaycees Christmas Parade right here in downtown Jefferson City. Beautiful night. Huge crowd here. And we've got another float coming up. I believe it's Concord Christian School.
The theme of their float is Jesus is the rock, and I'm on the roll of life. That's very, very good for rock and roll, isn't
that's
it?
That's a clever way of using the theme, isn't it? Looks like they've got a nice float here with several of their members. Merry Christmas from Concord Christian School.
I love it when people yell Merry Christmas.
Oh, yes.
It's nice to hear, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
You know, speaking of the trolley, they had a number of events within the last couple of weeks. We mentioned the Small Business Saturday, where the trolleys were downtown, giving rides, and I think that's good. It can be rented. You can, you know, it's a new opportunity for transportation in our community.
You are correct. And of course, Donna Dietz, president of the Downtown Association, and with the trolley company, a great community member, always active, doing all sorts of things.
That's right.
in Jefferson City.
Okay, we have Little Miss, Mr. and Miss Independence. On the float are the winners of the 2012 Little Miss and Mr. Independence Contest.
All right.
Sponsored by River Region Credit Union. Actually, I don't know what their names are, or we certainly would say, unless it's on the side of the float. If not, they're Mr. and Ms. Independence.
And they seem to have quite the entourage.
Yes,
that's always
they do.
Good, yes.
Aha, here comes Fatima High School homecoming band, or excuse me, first of all, I guess it's the band, and then the homecoming queen candidates will be following. Let's listen to the band. Good job, guys. Good job.
Of course, Fatima is one of the great communities that are surrounding Jefferson City.
I see one of my buddies there.
Yeah.
And behind them is the Central Bank float. I'll bet we're going to see some folks that we might know, Michael.
I suspect Central Bank, of course, a great community partner here in Jefferson City and throughout Central Missouri. They've put together a very nice float, haven't they?
Yes, they do. I love the puppy. Fun.
It's the Christmas dog.
And the pink ladies behind him.
Next we have, I believe this is Community Health Center of Central Missouri.
You know, the Community Health Center has a brand new executive director. His name is Don Hallman. He started about 3 weeks ago, so we're glad to have him. We're glad to have him in our community.
Oh yes. Now we have our mayor, Eric Strumpf,
and the mayor's dog.
Of course.
I see the mayor's dog, and of course his family.
Of course,
he's a lovely family.
Now, is Eric driving that car, or is that puppy driving the car?
I think the puppy's driving the car, but let's don't tell anybody.
No, no, let's not tell the police. It's
Hello, Mayor.
And of course, the first dog's name is Crackers.
Crackers. A lot of fun, a lot of energy. Let's see, they're followed by the St. Peter's Interparish School Girl Scouts.
And they've got a little rock and roll theme going on, yeah.
Rock and roll and their fans.
Yes. Oh, look at the strobes going now. Yeah. Merry Christmas from the
Good
Girl
job.
Scouts. Seems like everybody's having a really fun time with the rock and roll theme from this year's.
It's energizing.
Yeah, it sure is.
Of course, you're too young to remember those rock and roll years.
Of course I am, much too young.
Okay, the next group is the American Heritage Girls. It's a faith-based scouting group whose mission is to build women's integrity.
What a wonderful
mission statement.
Yeah, absolutely.
Wow. Good job.
They also have a little float with a nice rock and roll atmosphere. Hey, looks like they got a float there on their float.
A float on their float.
It's a float. Next, looks like we have the Osage Bend Cloverleafs. It's their four-H club, the Cloverleafs.
Alvin and the Chipmunks.
Oh, yes. It's the Alvin and the Chipmunks rock and roll.
Let's listen.
Nice work, kids from Osage Bend 4-H Club.
That one young lady showed me her teeth. She indeed has.
she's getting her two front teeth for
That's
Christmas.
Right.
That's great.
Okay, this is the 2012 Missouri Princess Sweetheart and Little Miss Missouri Princess. Madison Reed and Sarah Hall, they will be competing for the national title in Branson in March of next year, 2013.
I'm sure they'll be great representatives for our community.
Absolutely. Good job, Madison and Sarah.
Well, here's our friends from KRCG. Is that Zach Paul on top? Yeah.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Zach. Once again, another great media that we have here in Jefferson City, KRCG, Channel 13, CBS affiliate.
You know, we are fortunate in our community. We have media partners who are very involved with what's going on in the community, not just from a news standpoint, but from a volunteer standpoint.
Yes, we
as
do.
Well.
They really give back, and it's a wonderful thing.
We have a little bit of a stoppage here, but I wanted to mention the next float is Mac and Son Plumbing. That's a new float. I don't remember them being involved with the parade before.
I don't believe they have been involved.
They are wishing, their family is wishing all of Jefferson City a Merry Christmas and remind you to call them with your repair or remodel needs. So.
They've embraced the theme as well. Got a nice rock and roll theme. Is that Elvis up there?
And I love the gold commode.
The gold commode, yes. Nothing says rock and roll like gold commodes.
That's right. Good job.
And there's the Whaley's
smart car. Dressed up as Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, and they again want to wish everyone a Merry Christmas.
And now it's time for another band, the Jefferson City High School Band.
You know, Michael, a friend of mine knows a number of these trumpet players, and they have achieved some wonderful awards, not only district-wise, but also competing in the state as well. So I'm very proud of the musicians in our community, whether it's from Jefferson City High School or Elias or, you know, Fatima, or they have taken their opportunities to task.
A lot of talent in our young people.
Absolutely.
Is this the American Heart Association Heart Stars coming up?
Could very well be. If so, it's Gracie Strong, and she will be sharing her amazing story at the Heart Ball on February 9th.
Of course, we are still looking at more of the Jefferson City High School band and some of their vehicles.
You know, it takes a vehicle like that just to move their instruments around.
Yeah, you just can't put the instruments on your bike and go. You know, you have to
anymore.
Have a vehicle to transport them.
Okay, the UPS store, they are rocking and rolling, helping Santa deliver holiday happiness. They're working now so Santa doesn't have to work so hard later.
That's exactly right. They've got a nice little float themselves, don't they? Looks like we got another Cub Scout troop coming up. This is the St. Martin's Catholic School Cub Scouts. St. Martin's, Missouri, Pac-12. Merry Christmas.
They look like rock stars also.
Yes, they do. Oh, and they got some pups on their float as well.
Good job. This is the Nichols Career Center, FFA. They're taking you back to a classic dinner celebrating the holidays. Rock and Roll Diner.
Yeah, doing a little dancing, serving up some sodas. The Rock and Roll Diner, Nichols Career Center, FFA.
They're followed by the Jefferson City Nursing and Rehab Center.
And they've got a pretty nice float themselves, once again embracing the rock and roll theme for this year. Got some elves throwing out some candy. Well, folks, listen to the jukebox.
Oh,
and there's our American Heart Association Heart Stars.
Yes, here she is. We kind of announced her a little early. She'll be telling her story at the Heart Ball on February 9th.
February 9th,
I skipped ahead a few months, didn't I?
And I believe this is the Wardsville 4-H.
That's it. They're singing Jingle Bells and having a good time.
Oh, yes. From our good friends down in Wardsville.
This is the Jefferson City Police Department Explorers Post number 2. Yep, there they have
That's
Reddy
right.
Fox, the 9/11 mascot. They have Darren the Darer. Lion, and I don't know, do I see McGruff? No, McGruff's out McGruffing,
that's
I guess.
That's right. Well, here's a friend of ours. I believe that's Senator Mike Kehoe.
Absolutely. He yelled at his camera shot.
Hi, Mike.
Hi, Michael. God bless you. Merry Christmas. And his family. He's
Absolutely.
Got a great family. They're so nice. And there's John Sheehan and Barb walking right behind.
That's right. Now we have the Jefferson City Salvation Army. You know, this time of year it's important to give to the Kettle Campaign so that the Salvation Army can do all the great things that they do throughout the year. Salvation Army is another one of those organizations where you don't realize how important they are to the community until they're not there. And so we're very, very happy to have the Salvation Army, who provides all the services that they provide here in Jefferson City. You know, the shelter and the food pantry, just so many services provided by the Salvation Army.
I had the opportunity this past week to go over to the shelter and visit for a short time, and I think it's full. You know, it's sad to say in our community that there just are a number of individuals who struggle to find shelter and food, and you're absolutely right. We're very fortunate to have such a caring organization in our community.
So we, you know, obviously we want to ask everyone to, when you see the bright red kettles, please contribute.
Absolutely.
And now we have the Calvary Lutheran High School coming up.
Calvary Lutheran High School.
Looks like we begin with some of their cheerleaders, and then we got a float by Calvary Lutheran High School.
This trailer has a 30-foot church with stained glass windows and Christmas playing.
Wow.
Christmas music. Wow, look at that. Isn't that beautiful?
They did some great work on that.
They did wonderful work. Wow.
Hey, how are you up there?
Good job.
Oh, come let us sing to the Lord. Hello. What an outstanding job done on this float by Calvary Lutheran High School.
It's beautiful. Merry Christmas. I love to see all the youth participating in the parade.
Oh, it's great. Yep, coming up, looks like we've got Millard Funeral Homes, and then looks like that's Reed Millard up there.
That's right. This is a 1946 Chevrolet fire truck.
Beautiful truck. Seen this in a
couple
of parades this year.
And you know who's
with
me? Mike? Mike can play that piano, can
oh, yeah.
And sing.
Now we got the Helias High School Marching Crusaders.
They're led by their director, Eric Miley.
Looks like next we have the Missouri JCTV State President, Tricia O'Sheltry. She's the 91st president of the Missouri State JCTV. Next, I believe we have the Inspired Salon and Spa, a Christmas edition of Hairspray. You notice how all their hair looks so good.
Yes.
A little dancing, a little grooming.
All at the same time.
Jefferson City, let's see, that was the Inspired Salon and Spa.
Well, it says on the truck it's Lincoln University and it's KISS.
It's the LU Ag Department.
There you go. Look at them. Look at them dance.
The LU Aggies. Merry Christmas. Next we have the Elks Lodge 513. Thank a vet for a rockin' Christmas.
Thank you. You know, there were a lot of events during Veterans Day for people throughout the community and for veterans throughout the community. One of the most dramatic ones for me was when we were able to visit the two high schools. What a wonderful recognition. I don't know what it is, but it's beautiful.
This is still part of the Elks. They're Elks Rock and Roll Diner.
I don't know, but there's Elvis again.
There's Elvis.
Elks, here we go. It's Elks 513 post.
Once again, embracing the rock and roll theme from this year's parade. Well, it's been a great parade. The it's a great crowd, great weather, and these floats have just
been wonderful. I think, again, we've talked about it before, but a lot of energy. That's fun.
Oh, yes. You know? Well, everyone seems to be having a great time here. We've got the once again, we're still the Missouri Elks Association. This is their drug awareness program.
Now, they run a pretty nice drug awareness program, and I'm impressed with what they're doing. Followed by Solid Rock Family Church. They are presenting a musical drama, Annie's Greatest Gifts. So we're going to hear some music from Annie's Greatest Gift.
Solid Rock Family Church here in Jefferson City.
Fun.
Next we have looks like a Carol Rima vehicle. Followed by the Blair Oaks High School Marching Falcons, located in Wardsville, Missouri. I was never in a band. You know, I beat on some pots and pans as a child, but I don't think that qualifies as playing the drums.
I think I should have probably played drums rather than flute. Here's the Capital City Christian Church float. Students walking in costume alongside of the floats, and of course this wonderful manger scene.
Very, very nice float. But Capital City Christian Church.
And here we have Zimmer Radio Group, where country music meets rock, and a tribute to both. I'll bet Kevin Hillary's in there. Now there's Kevin.
There's Kevin Hillary right there, yes.
Hillary and Hart.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. God bless them.
Zimmer Radio Group's Kevin Hilly. Looks like, and here's the KWS vehicle. There's another Elvis.
That's it.
Yeah. And here's JJ Security and Investigations.
LLC.
Yes. They've got another little dog in there.
That's
if you can call
dog.
That little.
I was going to say, that's a big dog. Security patrol.
And here's a less intimidating dog.
I think they're new to the parade again this year.
I believe
too.
They are,
or
yes.
This year.
We've got a number of vehicles and folks walking in the parade. JJ Security. This is Toys to Children's Hospital.
This is an event that the JCs do each year, and they encourage, as part of the entry fee, so to speak, giving a toy, and then they share it with the Children's Hospital. It's a nice deal. And there we have Julie Morph. She's finally able to relax with the Christmas parade almost over.
That's exactly right. Julie Morph, the parade chair, had a few stressful months, but it's all coming to an end tonight,
yeah,
I think.
She did an outstanding job. She's a neat lady and has been very involved with the JCs, as we talked with her earlier.
And, of course, she is followed up by the 2012 parade co-chair, Jennifer Largent. Jennifer's throwing out a little candy to some kids here close. Not only plans the parade, participates and gives candy
That's
to
right.
the kids.
You know what? I think the big guy's coming.
Oh boy, who's this?
All the way from the North Pole. I think it's Santa and Mrs. Claus.
That's right, we've been waiting all parade. Here we are, the stars of the show.
They're going to be rocking and rolling during their visit to Jefferson City today.
All right, Santa and Mrs. Claus.
Oh, Merry Christmas.
Oh, yeah. That's Santa. I recognize that voice. God bless you, Santa. And here we have, of course, I love horses.
Yes.
The Nichols Career Center, FFA. They usually do come by with their horses. And, of course, at the end of the parade,
That's
we
right.
always have the Jefferson City finest who are protecting us all.
Absolutely. Well, it's been just a great, great parade. I mean, I know everybody that's been here has had such a great time. It's been real lively, a huge crowd, lots of great floats. You couldn't ask for better
Absolutely.
Weather.
Absolutely. And we want a special thanks to the City of Jefferson Parking Division, Jefferson City JCs, MediaCom Cable of Jefferson City. And, of course, we couldn't do this without our crew. Art Gerhardt, Dennis Gillis, Yuki Teramoto, Shauna, Anne Marie Scott, Shauna and Anne Marie Scott, and also the JCTV station manager, Gloria Inlow.
That's right. It's been a lot of fun here doing the parade here on JCTV. We want to thank everybody who's participating, everybody who's watching us here. And I guess it's time now to sign off and say it's been another great parade, and see you next year.
And good night and Merry Christmas to you all.